हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर आशा कदम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, दादा पाटील महाविद्यालय, कर्जत। फर्स्ट वेलकम टू ऑल। इन टुडेज सेशन वी आर लर्न अबाउट द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज द क्रिप्टोगैमिक बॉटनी। हियर as in previous lecture we learned that cryptogames means flowerless plants, but the contrast group, that is the phanerogames, in these phanerogames the plants which are belongs that always bears the flowers and the seeds. Let us study the phanerogames. Here these phanerogames is the word which is Greek phanerods. Phanerods is a Greek word, means visible, and gami means to marry. These phanerogames are also called as the spermatophyta. Sperma means seeds, and phyta means plants, means those plants which bear the seeds, that also called as the spermatophyta. You know that these phanerogames are bearing the flowers. As they bear the flowers, they also bears the fruits, and they also bear the seeds. And that's why these phanerogames is called as the spermatophyta. They prepare their own food material. They bears the flowers of different structures, different colors, and also bear the different types of seeds. They have well developed a reproductive system. Next, we learn about the classification of phanerogames. As we know that phanerogames means flowering plants, which are classified into the two groups, that is, first one is the gymnosperm and second one is the angiosperm. What is means by gymnosperm? Gymno and the sperm. Sperma means, as we know that sperma means seed, and gymno. Here in these gymnosperms, those plants which are included, all these plants having a seeds, but they are naked. Means in short, in the gymnosperms, the plants having the seeds, but they are easily seen our naked eyes. And that's why the distinct feature of these gymnosperm is the plants with naked eyes. For example, cycas, pinus, all these are the examples of a gymnosperms. We are seen around our surroundings, and these plants having these seeds, which are easily we are seen our naked eyes. And next group is the angiosperms. Here also the word is a sperma. Sperma means seeds, but here in these angiosperms, those plants which are included that having a seeds, but are enclosed always within the fruits. Means here the distinct feature of these angiosperma is the seeds are always enclosed into the fruit. For example, we say that custard apple having seeds, but they are enclosed into the fruits. These angiosperm again divided into the two classes, that is the monocotyledon, and second one is the dicotyledon. In the monocotyledon, the plant having a seed, but only one single cotyledon. In the dicotyledon, the seeds having a two cotyledons. So, plants which having the seeds with only single cotyledon, that we called as the monocotyledons, or in short, it also called as the monocot. For example, wheat, rice, etc. In the dicot, the plants having the seeds, but their cotyledons are two, means these seeds having a two cotyledons. For example, gram, pea, these are the some examples of a dicot. First group, that is the gymnosperm. As we learn that the gymnosperms having the seeds, but they are always naked. So they are naked seeded plant as their seeds are not enclosed into the fruit. This is the distinct or unique character of these gymnosperms, that is the seeds are always naked. When we learn the characteristic of the gymnosperms, that first we say that they do not produce the flowers and the fruits, but they having the seeds. They are wood trees and live for many years. The plant body is well developed into the root, stem and the leaves. For example, cycas, zamia, fig, deodar, these are the examples of a gymnosperms. Gymnosperms are divided into the distinct divisions, that is the cycadophyta, coniferophyta, gingophyta and netophyta, or it also called as the netophyta. According to the various classification system, they having a different suffix. Sometimes it also called as the, in some classification system, we also called as the cycadophyta, coniferophyta, gingophyta and the netophyta. The first one is the cycadophyta or the cycadophyta. Here the example is the cycas. Here in this picture we know that this one is the cycas. In our campus also there are 2 to 3 plants of cycas are present. Then the coniferophyta, in this coniferophyta the common example is the pinus. Here this one is the cone of this pinus. Then gingophyta, that is the maidenhair tree we called as the, and we know that this gingo biloba is the common example of this gingophyta. Then netophyta, here the common example of netophyta is a netum ula. The next group is the angiosperm. Angiosperms are the largest group among all the group of plants, constitute about 80% of all green plants, found in varieties of habitats. When we learn the characteristic of angiosperms, that time we say that they are autotrophs. Yesterday lecture we say that autotrophs means, auto means self and tropic means nourishment level, means for the nourishment purpose they prepare their own food material, that's why they are autotrophs. Their seeds are always enclosed inside the fruits. Plant of this group grow different habitats. Some are hydrophytes, some are mesophytes, some are xerophytes and some are also epiphytes. These angiosperms are further classified into the two classes, monocotyledon and next one is the dicotyledon. Here when we learn the monocot, that time the unique character is the presence of a single cotyledon in seed. Root system is fibrous, long narrow leaves with parallel venation. They have weak stem, and example of these monocot is the wheat, rice, barley, jawar, sugarcane, maize, etc. In the dicotyledons, the unique feature is two seeds leaves, means here in the seeds two cotyledons are present, broad leaves with reticulate venation. Taproot system is present. They have a strong stem, For examples, mango, citrus, orange, mustard, pea plant, all these are the examples of a dicot. Thank you. Today we are learn about the phanerogams. Here phanerogams means the flowering plants in which there are different groups, that is the gymno and the anchu. In these gymnosperm, seeds are naked, while as in angiosperm, seeds are enclosed into the fruit. Gymnosperm having a different phyla and angiosperms also having a different phyla or the class. These gymnosperms and angiosperms are distinct with their presence of seeds into the fruits or in outside the fruit. These are the unique character of these two groups, that is the angiosperms and the gymnosperms. Angiosperms again divided into the two classes, that is the monocot and the dicot, on the basis of their morphological and the anatomical characters. Okay, thank you.